So you may or may not have heard about this game called Ages of Conflict. If you have, good for you. But if you haven't, it's basically just this game that simulates war. And when I press scenarios, it brings me to a bunch of different maps and stuff and scenarios. And I'm gonna go with world map current year large, because bigger is better. And when I press simulate scenario, it brings me to the world map. And if you don't know what a world map looks like, you need to go back to school. But basically, I'm just gonna make all the alliances and stuff. So basically, USA side and Russia side. So I'll see you in about 17 seconds. Okay, so I just basically made NATO and BRICS pretty much. Or, well, I guess this is not BRICS, but it's just Russia's side, okay? I'm gonna press pause and I'm gonna see what happens. So, pretty much immediately, we're seeing the UK do UK things by invading Ireland. Also, we're seeing Saudi Arabia do Saudi Arabia things by invading Oman. Also, it looks like Switzerland finally neutralized itself by making an alliance with Slovenia. We're also seeing Ukraine pull a Uno reverse card on Russia. Damn. It also looks like Germany is trying to relive the days of the German Empire. Well, let's hope the thing that happened last time doesn't happen this time. Well, the United States got revenge from 1812. USA, gotta warn you, big boy North Korea is rising up. Also, I forgot to mention that Turkey looks like this now. Okay, not much is happening, so I'm just gonna put this on a time lapse and see what happens. So I'll see you in like 30 seconds. Been about 15 minutes, and the United States and Brazil are having a friendly conversation about who should control each other. Kazakhstan got really big, and Lithuania suddenly controls everything. Nice, but I'm getting kind of bored, so I'm just gonna make every country go to war with each other and see what happens. So, this isn't gonna go well. Yeah, I think this is good.
Touching hands. Reaching out, touching me, touching you.